So greetings to all of you. Today we are starting the new chapter, that is human health and diseases. So in COVID era, we all are anxious about our health. And whenever we talk about health, we actually think about well-being of our body. But as per the definition suggested by WHO, health doesn't only include the correct food, it includes everything. So if you talk about WHO definition of health, it says that it is well-being of body, mind, as well as social well-being. I wish to highlight over here, beta, that if a person is taking correct amount of food, having daily exercises, but in mind is having some kind of stress, anxiety, depression, it is bound to have that effect on the body of the person. Why? Because in stress condition, we are obviously affected by the constant kind of feeling which is dragging us down. Okay, the person may not have proper sleep. The funny part is we always ignore the mental and social part. And most of the time we are so ignorant that we don't identify. Hame pata bhi nahi chalta hai कि कब हम अनहेल्दी बन जाते हैं. आप पूछोगे मैम हम तो बच्चे हैं हमें क्यों बोल रहे हो. यू विल नॉट बिलीव बेटा, डे बाय डे हार्ट अटैक्स इन योर एज ग्रुप चिल्ड्रन, डायबिटीज इन योर ग्रुप एज ग्रुप चिल्ड्रन इज इंक्रीजिंग विच वर नॉट देयर एट माय एज. जब मैं आपके उम्र की थी ऐसा हम सुनते नहीं थे कि बच्चा हार्ट अटैक से मर गया, हम खुश रहते थे. So we need to observe, this chapter is not only a chapter. I want all of you to think and retrospect what is the important thing in our life. Kyunki bola jata hai jaan hai to jahan hai, hai na? Baki sab cheeze is zaruri, but jaan is required. So with this positive note, I am starting this chapter. So even if a person is socially not healthy, जैसे ऐसे किसी सोसाइटी जहां पे फीमेल फोर्टिसाइड को सोचा जाता है, जहां पे फीमेल्स को आफ्टर बर्थ दे आर किल्ड बिकॉज पीपल फील दैट सिर्फ मेल मेंबर्स ही वंश को आगे बढ़ाते हैं. डू यू बिलीव इन सच सोसाइटी वेर फीमेल फोर्टिसाइड इज कॉमन दोज पर्सन कैन हैव अ हेल्दी लाइफ? नो. So when I want to be healthy, I need to be healthy by my body, by my mind, and by my social thinking also. Okay. So why we need to be healthy? क्यों हमारे life में ये aim रहता है that we want to be healthy? Which life do you prefer? You want to live long without health? Or you want to be healthy and have a short lifespan? Which one is preferred by most of the people? Class?
Healthy and short life.
So if you are, the fun is, if you are healthy, unless there is an accident, generally person lives long. Okay. So how health can be maintained? So it was thought by ancient people, like if you go through Ayurveda system or even the Greek literature, they used to think about the balance of body and mind. Jise hum bolte yin and yang, Chinese mein bataya jata hai. You know, there is a white half circle and a black half circle. Okay. It is also thought about the balance of good and बैड. सो बोला जाता था कि अ पर्सन विद ब्लैक बाइल, जिसे हम बोलते पित, दे हैव अ हॉट पर्सनैलिटी एंड हैव मोर टेंडेंसी टू अफेक्ट फ्रॉम फीवर. हाउ? Because they used to identify by the four type, one is black bile, yellow bile, phlegm and blood. Okay, later on it was discovered and strong correlation was done between the liquid part of our body and the other organs. Why blood or humor is so important? Because beta, it is actually connecting different parts of our body. If a person is having unhealthy circulation, then required things will not reach to the part where it is supposed to reach, and things which is to be removed is not also removed. That's why later on it was discovered by different scientists about the neural system, endocrine system, immune system, and all these things, how they control the health, it was discovered. So it's said that every human being is the author of his own health or disease. You choose how you want to be. So what are the factors that affect health? I mentioned here about things. So amongst them, in point number one, we don't have any control. Do we have any control over genetic disorder? Can we control it? Class, what do you think?
No, ma'am.
I think we can. How? How we can even control genetic disorders if we are wise enough? Class? By checking before marriage, it is required better. Kundli milane se pehle, you go genetic analysis of the person. Now, should everyone do it? No. The families in which there is a trend of genetic disorders like hemophilia, color blindness, or other autosomal or sex link disorders, they can have a check with the person whom they are getting married. Okay. Even I said that in our country, at the embryo stage, amniocentesis is not allowed, but in foreign countries, it is allowed. Okay. I told you, if a mother is aged and she is suspecting that due to non-disjunction, the child can suffer from Down syndrome, with special permission, they can go for the chromosome mapping. Don't you think it is good to abort a child at correct stage than to let it live a life which is painful? What do you think, class? If you know a person is going to suffering from progeria, jisme 16 saal ki umar mein wo budha hoke mar jayega, do you think we should keep that child or it can be aborted at the correct moment?
Abort.
So that is possible if we are conscious. In our case, many a times we miss such things. We should not miss such things. It is very important for a person to be conscious. So that's why once there is genetic disorder, we cannot do anything other than reducing the symptoms, because it is not curable. But before that, we can prevent. Similarly, if infection is there, there is possible of treatment. And if we know what type of infection, the fight of ours against COVID-19 is by preventing the COVID-19, by preventing the spread, by breaking of the chain. So that is possible. Third thing is also in our control, that is diet, rest and exercise. It is said that a person should have 8 hours sleep. I don't know last time when I slept for 8 hours, But it is said that it is required. You need to have proper amount of rest, diet, and exercise. Then only a person can be healthy. Okay. So there are diseases which are mixed. For example, diabetes. It is occurring due to bad lifestyle. Also, genetic influence is there in case of diabetes. So if we know what is the aim, why we should learn this chapter? In every chapter we study this. कि हम ये chapter क्यों पढ़ेंगे? क्या फायदा? Apart from like gaining knowledge and gaining marks in CBSE or Gujarat Board 12th grade, what is the aim of studying this chapter? So how this chapter can be helpful to you, class?
By knowing different types of diseases in our body.
So that you are better exposed. Agar tumko ya tumhare family mein kisi ko typhoid hua for not for forbidden, then you know what is typhoid. Even if there is by chance any wrong medication by doctor or from something, you know about it. You are not blind. So we will move ahead. So health is about everything. Even small things in our life are deciding health. If there is not proper bowel movement, a person is having constipation, it may be leading to health, bad health. Why? Because all our body parts are connected. Bad digestion means it will have effect in other organs also. If we are not maintaining the personal hygiene, we are not clean enough, the house in which we are staying is not clean enough, we will obviously get affected to the diseases. What lifestyle we are leading? Are we leading sedentary lifestyle in which we do not go for exercise? Are we not taking food at time? Are we not taking food which is good for our health? So what is balanced diet? It should have protein, fat, carbohydrate, minerals, vitamins, and water. Yes, fat is also equally important. Okay. And apart from that, social and mental will be. So, what are the characters of good health? How can we say that this person is healthy? Many a times we feel hame ek misconception hai. कि किसी इंसान का सिक्स पैक एब है तो वो हेल्दी है. डू यू थिंक दैट पर्सन इज हेल्दी? क्लास, आई विल गिव यू वन एग्जांपल. हैव यू एवर थॉट अबाउट हर्ड अबाउट आर्नोल्ड श्वार्ज़नेगर, टर्मिनेटर सीरीज? There is a hero. Class?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you ever heard about Arnold Schwarzenegger? Or about the man who has largest bicep in the world? You search it in the internet, that the man with largest bicep in the world. His bicep is so large that he cannot comb his hair. क्योंकि हेयर को कोम्ब करने के लिए दिस पार्ट शुड बेंड, नो? उसका बाइसेप इतना बड़ा है कि ही कैन नॉट कोम्ब हिज हेयर प्रॉपरली. सो डू यू थिंक दैट पर्सन इज हेल्दी? सो बीइंग हेल्दी इज नॉट ऑलवेज मेजर्ड अबाउट द फिगर और द जीरो फिगर और द सिक्स पैक एब. इट इज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मेनी थिंग्स. इज दैट पर्सन्स इम्यून सिस्टम स्ट्रॉन्ग इनफ? अच्छा चलो, आई गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल. यू नो मेनी ऑफ द स्पोर्ट्स मैन, दे ड्रिंक अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ वॉटर. हैव यू हर्ड? क्रिस्टलाइज्ड वॉटर. वन बॉटल कॉस्ट फॉर्च्यून. एक इंसान का एक टाइम का खाना हो जाए उसमें, उससे भी ज्यादा. सो व्हाई दे ड्रिंक सच काइंड ऑफ वॉटर? कैन यू टेल देयर इम्यून सिस्टम्स आर स्ट्रॉन्ग इनफ टू सस्टेन इन नॉर्मल कंडीशन? इज इट अ गुड प्रैक्टिस? you know, worldwide it was observed that poor people who are habituated to stay in harsh condition are less susceptible to diseases. उनके जो बच्चे हैं वो रस्ते में पड़े हुए खाना भी खा लेते, दे डोंट हैव स्टमक इन्फेक्शन. वेयरएज हमारे घर में बच्चों को थोड़ी सी भी कुछ गंदी मिल जाए खाने में, दे हैव डायरिया एंड अदर थिंग. व्हाई? सो हेल्दी पीपल डजंट डिफाइंड बाय द फिजिक और द फिगर, इट इज अबाउट देयर एबिलिटी टू फ्री फ्रॉम सिकनेस, फ्री फ्रॉम अननेसेसरी एंग्जाइटी. कुछ लोगों के पास बहुत पैसे होते हैं, हम बैठ के सोचते यार मेरे पास काश पैसा होता मैं ये गाड़ी खरीद. वो इंसान सोचता है बाप रे मेरे पास इतना पैसा है चला ना जाए. किसी को ऐसा लगता है कि उसके पास मेरे से ज्यादा पैसा क्यों है. वी शुड नॉट से दैट पर्सन इज हेल्दी. दे शुड नॉट हैव साइकोलॉजिकल टेंशन, अगर ये हो गया तो क्या हो गया. Lack of self-confidence, feeling of joy in living is missing in their lives. Ability to work efficiently. As a student, how efficiently you are studying. As a teacher, how efficiently I am teaching. That is also indication of my good health. So, do you all agree that these are the characters of good health? How many of you think that you are healthy? Can you raise your hand? I myself do not always feel that I am healthy. So all of you feel you are healthy? Nakshatra, Deesh, Kausha, Mishka? You people can hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So you people feel you are healthy? Think about it, okay? You think about it. So now we will come back to the part which is called types of diseases. So diseases can be classified into two types. One is congenital disease, that means inborn disease, which is genetical diseases like hemophilia, color blindness. Now though you can tell about like thousand of the diseases and you know that they can be due to gene mutation or chromosomal mutation. Apart from this, some diseases are there which we are not born with. Okay, we actually get them after our birth. So these are called acquired diseases, which are non-inheritable. They are not transmitted from one generation to other generation. For example, there can be communicable or infectious disease which get communicated from one person to another person by means of air, water, food, whatever it is. And there can be non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease which cannot be communicated from one person and other person. So from where, what is the source of non-communicable diseases? Mishka, aapko kya lagta hai? Kyun non-communicable diseases hote honge? There is no infectious agent here. Look into the diseases and let me know. Mishka, are you there with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Kyun hota hoga non-communicable disease? Why it is there?
Maybe kind of heredity or something.
No, heredity to kaise hoga acquired diseases mein? We are talking about acquired disease that we get after birth. Anyone wish to say ke non-communicable diseases hone ke reason? Yes, Yesha. Deesh is also raising hand. Yes, Deesh, bolo.
Due to our lifestyle.
Both of them say together, correct. Due to our lifestyle, due to our food habit, our sleeping pattern, our sedentary lifestyle, extra exercise, over exercise, deficiency of nutrients, all these are responsible for non-communicable disease. Okay, although I must say that there may be some non-living agent responsible for disease. For example, if a person is having asthma attack, it may be due to some chemicals. For example, I will always cite my example. I am acutely asthmatic and I am allergic to cement. One grain of cement and I have sneezing and breathing problem. Okay, so there may be non-living agents also. It's not always about the lifestyle. So this is the flow chart of communicable, non-communicable diseases. So now we will know what is pathogen. Pathogen is the living substances which cause the disease. Okay. So obviously pathogens are obligate parasites. They stay in our body. They take advantage of our body and cause harm to us. Okay. So disease is having their unique pathogen, unique symptoms, and unique mode of infection. Agar koi disease, digestive system disease hai, to wo digestive system ko hi affect karega. And generally, it is never transmitted by air or it is never transmitted by some other means. It will be transmitted by a method in which food and water is involved, because these are the things which is directly going to the digestive system. Very rarely the transmission method changes. Okay. So in every disease, when we are going to study about the disease, we need to understand a few things. First of all, what is the disease? What is the causative organism? The one which is causing the disease. Third thing we need to know, what is the mode of infection, by which means disease is spreading from one person to other person. Fourth thing is, what is the symptom of the disease? That, how can you identify, okay, symptoms are unique characteristics by which you can identify, okay, this is the disease. And in symptoms, you need to know that which is the target organ. For example, for diarrhea, the target organ is digestive system. Okay. For brain fever, that is called meningitis, the target organ is brain. What is the target organ of COVID virus? Class? Coronavirus. SARS-CoV-2. What is the target organ of this virus? Till now we know.
Lungs.
Or rather to say it a respiratory system, because first type infection occur in the trachea. Okay. So this is why this disease is transmitted by air, not by food. Because air can directly go to the respiratory system. So in our next lecture, we will talk about various diseases this way, by causative agent, epidemiology means how they spread, about the symptoms and how we can prevent it. Obviously, if you know the epidemiology of a disease, that how they spread, you yourself will have idea. For example, if any disease is caused by a vector like mosquito, the way to prevent that disease is getting rid of that thing or preventing yourself to get exposed to mosquitoes. Okay, so with this, I am finishing my lecture today, and we will discuss next day about different types of diseases. You correlate with yourself, because so much data, without correlation, it will be very difficult for you people to remember. Agar aap aise sochoge ki typhoid ki epidemiology kaise yaad rakhoge, it is difficult. Correlate. Okay, inko typhoid hua tha. What were the symptoms? So this way you will be able to remember them. Any question from your side, beta? Up to now, whatever we studied. Class. Okay, one thing I wish to share with you, that two diseases, that is diabetes and cancer, is part of lifestyle, is part of infection, and sometimes genetic also. Although there is no proper identification of gene-caused diabetes, it is predicted by a lot many doctors that it is genetic. Okay. Same in case of cancer, there are viruses which are known as oncogenic virus. Their presence in our body can alter the genetic makeup and can cause cancer. Yes, Dish.
Diabetes is not a disease.
It is a disease. Definitely. It is the deadliest disease in the world. You may laugh, ki ma'am, kya bol rahe ho? इंसान सालों डायबिटीज को साथ में लेके जीता है. हाउ कैन डायबिटीज बी डेडली डिजीज? बिकॉज इट इज अ साइलेंट किलर बेटा. द थिंग इज दैट इफ अ पर्सन इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम डायबिटीज, इफ द पर्सन इज नॉट टेकिंग प्रॉपर केयर, देन स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली इट विल डिस्ट्रॉय द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द बॉडी. एंड देन ड्यू टू डायबिटीज अ पर्सन विल हैव वीक हार्ट, वीक लंग्स, बैड किडनी, bad respiratory system, even bad nervous system also. Understood? So this is one of the most deadliest diseases, although we don't talk about it much. Usme kya hota hai? Because instant death does not take place, that's why we are not paying that much attention to it. And it cannot be cured, but it can be controlled. If you are taking a proper diet, proper exercise, proper everything, then it can be controlled. Any other question, anyone? Class?
Okay.
If it is a no, then yes, Gia, you wish to ask something better?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so then we will conclude our lecture here today. We will meet next week and we will discuss about the different types of disease. Okay, so bye to all of you, beta.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, beta.